Halo everyone, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Welcome back to my class Teknologi Pengendalian Hama. Okay, with me again, Ibu Lutfi Afifah. Well, now we will study about insect again. After the previous semester, you already study about the insect from order to order, from order to another family. So you already know. But now we will study more about insects. In our first meeting, we will study about the human insect relationship. Human and insect relationship. So what is the relationship between human and insect? Is that harm to the human, or the insect have a beneficial role in human life? We will know from these lectures. Okay. Now, as you can see in this picture, this is the coleopteran insect, coleoptera insect. The family is Carabaeidae. So this is called dung beetle, and in the ecosystem, this dung beetle is like a the role is decomposer, so they can decompose the organic matter. In the picture, this is the feces of other animal. They make the feces into the ball, and they decompose. And this is the unique behavior of this insect. So before they decompose this organic matter, they make a ball. So interesting. Okay, now we will. This is the class contract. In this Teknologi Pengendalian Hama, we will have about 14 online meeting. It depends on the lecture itself. We can use Google Classroom or YouTube or Google Meet or Zoom. And 10 minutes before the class, the student should be ready into the YouTube and Google Meet. And after in my class using Google Form, and you have to fill this Google Form and proving your online attendance. And then in these lectures, there are four lectures that will join us. Not only me, but also Pak Sugiarto, Bapak Satrio, and Ibu Fauzia Mustikasari. And in this lectures, there is also group work presentation. And the group work will be different time in each class. And this practical class will be guided by assistant and lecturers. The assistants, the name is Dana and Aziza. It will be combined between online and offline class. So this is the class schedule and platform. This is the class assessment. The final mark of your TPH class. This is the percentage, process, and then midterm, and then was 50% in this process, 25% and 25%, and this percentage might be a change. It could be changed following the distribution of every class F values, and it will be changed if the roles of the faculty different. I will talk to you later about this percentage, but in this class, you should follow all of the practical class, the practical work, and you have to be active in the class, and you have you have to do your projects, group works, and you have to attend the class. Okay, and then this is student assignment, individual work. It's like before, there is a weekly resume, and or maybe you have to answer in the question in the end of the slides. Okay, it's prefer handwriting, so please be creative. I want you to be more creative and use many colors. It's more interesting. And in this class also there is a group work discussion via Google Meet or Zoom. Its class is divided by 6 groups, and the presentation should be written in English, and PPT template, I will give you PPT template. No more than 3 slides per group in about 3 minutes, so it's really short presentation. And the group work would be delivering specific theme. We will give you later about this specific theme. And then, okay, now this is our first lectures. I will remind the previous lectures from biotic. This is all of insects that you already know. There is a fly, Sarcopachydae. As you can see, the thorax is like a chess box or papan catur, chessboard. And this is Apis, the family is Apidae, Pollinator, and this is Coccinellidae. This is, you already know that Coccinellidae that have a shiny morphology. It's like in the pictures, it's act as a predator. And this is Dermatera, we call it as Cecopet, as a predator. And this is herbivore Cicadidae, Tongeret. And this is the parasitoid, Hymenoptera. As you can see, this is the ovipositor, they deposit their egg. So they inject their egg into this larvae. So the egg will be live inside this larvae, so they will eventually kill this larvae. This is the biological agents, and this is the herbivore. This is Felidae. The order is Phasmatodea. It's like a leaf. It's like a guava leaf. So there is there are a lot of insects in our surrounding. They act as saprophag. They act as pollinator, predator. They act as other biological agents and etc. So yeah, this is more about the basic introductory of insect. What is insect and what they do? They do many things in our life. Okay, let's move. Okay, now we move to the evolution of insect. Based on the data, insect has been in this world longer than human. 410 million years ago, they are already present in this world. Okay. And life started from the sea but eventually moved to the land. As you can see, in this slide, Insect dominated in this earth from the Paleozoic era. This is how they first evolved in the period of Devonian. So it's about 410 million years ago, they already present in this world, Paleozoic Devonian. Okay, but not only the insect itself, but fish, arthropods, amphibians, reptiles, plants, is already evolved in that era. Okay, this is Paleozoic and Devonian. The timeline established by the researchers indicate that insects started colonizing the planet around the same time as plants, and in some cases even earlier. So some of the researchers prove that the insects starting colonizing the earth is around the same time as the plant. So the plant evolved, so the insect evolved too. And the flying insect evolved is the first appearance. After complex ecosystem had already developed online. Okay, this is the period that's important in insect, Paleozoic Devonian. And as you can see, there are about 32 insect orders in this world, and even more. At least more than 17 insect order you already know. You already study about Colembola. It's present in our surrounding. You already study about Odonata, flying insect, Ephemeroptera, Zoroptera, Dermaptera is like cecropod, Orthoptera is like a grasshopper, cricket, Phasmatodea. Phasmatodea is like a belalang ranting or belalang daun. Mantodea is praying mantis, Blattodea is like cockroach, Isopteran is like termite, Tisamnopteran is like a thrips. Hemiptera is like a bug, is like a hopper. Worm. Hymenoptera is like ants and bees. Neuroptera is like undur-undur, and lion in English. Coleoptera is a bug too. This is Kumbang in Indonesia. Lepidoptera is like a butterfly. Siponoptera is like a kutu kucing. Diptera is like a flies and nyamuk, mosquito, and many things that you already know about this insect order. And evolution of insect, we still study about evolution. Evolution has produced an astonishing variety of insect. Incredible variety of insect. Most of the major order of insect alive today were distinguishable 250 million years ago. They already distinguishable. They have their name about 250 million years ago. The first appeared in the fossil record for 400 million years ago during the Devonian period. And this is the oldest insect fossil that already known. The species is Rhynchocnathisti. This is the fossil. And this is the oldest known insect fossil, and and the picture of the old fossil proved that they have been in this world. And it was found in a red sandstone in Scotland, in a rocks, di bebatuan ya. So, okay, it's proof that insect is already in this world since about 400 million years ago. And insect is dominant group of organism in this earth. Why all this world is dominating by insect? How they can do? Yeah, we will study later why the insect is dominate the world. Insect represent half of the world biodiversity. Can you imagine half of the world biodiversity is represented by insects, and potentially over 90% of animal life form on Earth are insects, and they can be found in all environment, nearly all environment. This is the kingdom. The kingdom is Animalia, phylum Arthropoda, class Insecta. And insect may have gregarious or solitary. Gregarious, the mean is they can live together, or solitary. Solitary is some of insect they live by themselves. They didn't make a colony. For example, the ant, they are gregarious. They live in a colony, but solitary, they do by their self, menyendiri ya, solitary, gregarious bersama-sama. They can mimic of other subjects. They can camouflage to another insect, or they can camouflage into another animal. So they can defend themselves from the danger. And insect may be active or by day or night, as you know that some of insects have a diurnal behavior. Diurnal is it mean they active in a day, active di siang hari, and nocturnal they active in the night, and crepuscular they active in twilight, di petang. Okay, why these insects dominate the world? Yeah, so why this insect is already present in this world since Devonian era, Devonian period, and they still in this world today. So they have a success evolution. They survive from environment. Why they can success and they can dominate the world? Because their size is small size. Some of insect, yeah, mostly of insect have a small size. Yeah, the small size, so their reproduction could be shorter than the big size organism. Yeah, the period of generation. Ya, generasinya biasanya reproduksinya tuh lebih pendek ya. The tracheal respiratory system is the respiratory trachea, as you can see is this is the tracheal system. They have tabung Malpighi ya. The name is Malpighi tube. In the system trachea, they can helps the insect in taking the air from outside into the cell. And they have a variety of food. Some of insect, the food is a plant, and some of insect, the food is other organism, which is they can act as a biological agent. And some of insect, they act as saprophag. They eat organic matter, so they have a great variety of food. High adaptability. Some of insect, they can live in extreme environment. Short generation, yeah. The short generation, they're reproductive. Their reproduction is shorter than the big organism, as I told you before. The metamorphosis, as you know, they have four metamorphoses. Some the metamorphosis is ametabola, some is hemimetabola, some of insect holometabola, and some of insect paurometabola. So they have a different metamorphosis and different ways of living, different ways of giving birth. Yeah, wings in adults. Some of insects have wings, so they can disperse easily from one field into another field, from one region into another region. And the most species-rich insect order, yeah. What is the most species-rich? Yeah, we know that the insect have many orders, but the most species insect order is Coleoptera, beetles, and Hymenoptera. And this is still debatable. Hymenoptera, some of the researchers says that Hymenoptera is the most species rich orders, yeah. And Diptera and Lepidoptera, so this is four orders that are more rich than another order, yeah. Coleoptera, Hymenoptera, Diptera, and Lepidoptera. This is Kumbang Hymenoptera. It's like ants, bees, wasps, tawon, yeah. Diptera is like nyamuk, flies, lalat. Lepidoptera is like moth and butterfly. You already know that there is a differences between moth and butterfly. Moth is ngengat and butterfly is kupu-kupu. How many insects in Indonesia? A lot of insect is in Indonesia. It's more about 2,500 species of insect in Indonesia. 15% of all known fauna in Indonesia, but about only 10% of beetle in the world, in this world, has found in Indonesia. 10% of beetles in this world. So our biodiversity is great. So there are a lot of insects that already distinguishable. They already have name. Okay, and then we talk about biodiversity. What happened in our biodiversity? Our biodiversity, biodiversitas, keanekaragaman ya, is declined. Menurun. Why our biodiversity decline? Yeah, we just not losing insect or bees. The problem is much greater. But we also losing wetland, for example. Yeah. Kita tidak hanya kehilangan serangga ataupun bees atau lebah, kita juga kehilangan lahan, ya, lahan, dan juga kehilangan fresh water. We are losing tremendously. Kita kehilangan banyak kehilangannya. Why our biodiversity is declined? One of the problem is our agriculture. Agriculture is far too simplified. Most of the agriculture is monoculture. As we know that If the field is monoculture, so only some of the species that dominate that ecosystem. Some of the organism is so minimal. So our agriculture is too simplified. Loss of insect biodiversity and abundance is expected to provoke cascading effect on food webs. So if our agriculture is too simplified, for example monoculture, so it will affect on the food webs, on the ecosystem inside that habitat. Yeah, it's affect the food webs. The food webs is also simplified also, and also effect on ecosystem surfaces. What is ecosystem surfaces? Ecosystem surfaces is how the ecosystem give the benefit to human. How the ecosystem give the benefit to human? Yeah, for ecosystem. Okay, for example, what we can gain for the agro ecosystem itself. If we plant the paddy, so we will get the rice. So this is what ecosystem give to us. For example, forest ecosystem. What forest can give to us? The forest give us the wood. Yeah, and then the forest also give us, for example, their product is animal and other. Also from aquatic ecosystem, we can gain the fish, for example. Also from insect, what insect can do for us? Insect have many things that they can do for our life. For example, we can produce the honey from the insect. We can get wax from insect. Yeah, we can get wax. And another from the pollinator, insect give us benefit to our field. They can pollinate our flower. They can pollinate our crop. So the insect itself already help us. Yeah. So this is what ecosystem surfaces. Loss of insect is certain to have adverse effect on ecosystem functioning. So loss of biodiversity, loss of insect have a bad impact to us. Insect play a central role in a variety of process, including pollination. They can pollinate, from example, from the pictures. As you can see, this is Apis. Apis in all over the body, they cover by the nectar. Yeah, so they can pollinate from one plant into another plant. Herbivory and detritivory. So for example, this is how predatory ecosystem surfaces. Insects also give other organism food. For example, the birds can eat insects. So this is also ecosystem surfaces. This is part of food webs. Yeah? Food webs, jaring-jaring makanan. Okay. From insect itself, we can produce honeybee, and we can produce silk from a Bombyx mori. Bombyx mori is a caterpillar that can produce silk sutra. For example, 80% of fair plants are estimated to depend on insect for pollination. So, most of the plants, it still depend on the insect to pollinate their plants. Yeah, and while 60% of birds still rely on insect as a food source. If we lost insect, so our food webs is also disturbing. Okay, so now we move to where do insect live. Insect live in a variety of habitat. They can live in a forest, the desert, grassland, cave, paddy field, plantation, horticulture, and other. So they can live everywhere. Insect friends of our enemies. Some of insect have a beneficial roles. Yeah, some of insect have bad impact to crop. They can act as a pest. And the majority of insect are beneficial or neutral. However, an important minority of insect do great harms to humans, plants, and other animals. Yeah, some of insect act as a pest to plants, and some of insect also can disturb another animal. Yeah, as a parasite. For example, from the Diptera tabanidae. Yeah? They can do bad to animals like cow. How insect beneficial to human? Insect as food. Now we can eat insect. Insect now is one of the protein source. Yeah? Now we search for another protein source. Insect as food or edible insect. Edible insect. What is edible insect? Insect that are species used for human consumption. We can eat whole insect, or we can process that insect into another products, as we can the products like the burger patties in Europe. We can find patties from insect. You can see in the picture, this is insect burger. And we can okay, and some of insect in another country, they serve as snack or pasta. As you can see, this is cricket cookies, and this is cookies made with ants, and this is chocolate chips. It's incredible. And the culture and biological process of eating insects is described as entomophagy. So this is the term how to define the culture on biological process of eating insects. The increased consumer interest in Western markets such as Europe and North America, and some of the insects they have been processed into non-recognizable form. So in Europe, for example, they process the insect into the powders or flour. So mereka membuat itu menjadi tepung. So this is the non-recognizable form. So they can use insect flour as an ingredient to make, for example, to make a cookie and other. There are some potential challenges to produce this insect. Yeah, there are a lot of challenges how to make insect as food. Yeah, so we should produce the insect itself. Okay, the mass production, it's still our challenge to produce insect. So we cannot depend if we use insect as our food. We cannot depend the insect from the environment. We should meet the mass reproduction. Kita harus mengembangbiakkan sendiri ya. But the challenge is in our country is lack of technology to produce the rearing is produce insect. Yeah, to rearing the insect. So we still have challenge, and the machinery we still have many challenges in our country. Okay, threats to food safety. Yeah? The food is safe if the food is free from biological agents. Food if is free if they are not only free from biological agent but also free from physical and free for a chemical agent. So this is the challenge how to make insect as human food especially in Indonesia. Okay, so this is threats to food safety. Yeah, biological agent. So if we make insect as food, so we make sure that insect there is no contamination in biological and physical and chemical. For example, biological, we should make sure that insect is not contaminated with other organism, for example parasites. Yeah, and physical is contamination physic. Yeah, so the insect itself should free from foreign objects that enters the food. Yeah, for example the media to breeding that insect. Yeah, it should be free if we use insect to our food, and should be free from chemical. Yeah, so this is the challenge how to make insect as food. Yeah, this is food safety. Yeah, should be free from biological contaminant, physical and chemical contaminant. Insect as a medicine, as you can see, this is a maggot. The maggot therapy is a biotherapy that involves the introduction of live maggot fly larva into the skin as soft tissues wounds of human or animal for the purpose of cleaning out the necrotic or dead tissues. So this is what the doctors do. Some of the doctors do this. Yeah, so they use maggot to cleaning the wound of human and animal. This is the journal that prove that insect could be potential medicinal significance. Yeah, they can help to cleaning the wounds. This is insect producing a valuable products. Yeah, so we can commercialization of the insects. Insect can be a big business. For example, insect and their product are sold for crop pollination. In some of the country, some of the company, they sell insect for pollination. Yeah, and some of insects have a beneficial pharmaceutical impact. And for research and for works of art, for example, this is the insects, yeah. Watch beetle, living generally in the market, Mexico. Yeah, this is generally that this is the insect, and this is the royal jelly. Royal jelly also produced by the honeybee. Okay, and this is the beeswax. The beeswax. Yeah, this beeswax is we can use beeswax in our life. Okay, this is the silk. How the silk made is from this caterpillar. This is Bombyx mori. Bombyx mori can produce the silk. Yeah, Ulat Sutra. And then insect producing a valuable product, as you can see in the slide. So there are two differences of bees. Bees divided into the honey and non-honey. Non-honey, for example, is bumblebee, is non-honey, but they can still help to pollinate the crops. And this bumblebee is mostly used in Europe. They use bumblebee to pollinate the crops, and some of the company sell this bumblebee. So they sell bumblebee into the box, and then this bumblebee can help to pollinate the crops in the greenhouse. And this is the bees that produce honey, divided into two, apiculture and meliponiculture. What is the differences between apiculture and meliponiculture? The apiculture comes from the Latin words apis. Apis is meaning, the meaning is bee. So apiculture or beekeeping is the care of management of honeybees for the production of honey and wax. So this is the apis. This is how they're like they can all over their body, they can hold the nectar. The species of honeybee, for example, Apis mellifera, Apis serrania, and other Apis. And what is the differences between apiculture and meliponiculture? So this honeybee, mostly they have sting, so they can sting us. Mereka punya sengat. But the meliponiculture is stingless bee, so they didn't have sting. Yeah, it's a sustainable activity, the activity that does not harm to the environment. They didn't harm to the environment, but they still have a provide valuable products such as honey and propolis. Also helps to increase productivity of several crops. And the species of the apiculture and meliponiculture is different. While the apiculture, most of the species come from the genus Apis, while the meliponiculture is stingless bees. Stingless bees are small species of stingless bee. As you can see in the picture, stingless bee is trigona. This is different size between Apis and trigona. This is Apis and this is trigona. Trigona is really small. Okay, this is how the nest of honeybee Apis, and this is the nest of stingless bee. They can found mostly found in bamboo. Yeah. their nest is inside the bamboo. This is the nest of stingless bee, Trigona. You can see in internet searching trends, honeybee and bees. Honeybee most of the people in this world, they interest about the product of insect honey, but they didn't interest in the insect itself, which is bee. This is interesting because most of the people only focus on the product itself, but they didn't realize that bees is behind the honey. This is the nest, the artificial nest of stingless bee Trigona. As you can see in the slide, this is the box, and in the box there is a tiny hole. This tiny hole is the entrance of the stingless bee. Okay. Another insect as the essential food chain in the ecosystem. So, yeah. This is how the food webs. The food webs is jaring-jaring makanan. So in our ecosystem, there are a bunch of relationship. There are a bunch of the relationship between plants and from one animal to another animal. For example, this insect also have a specific role in the ecosystem. We can imagine if there is the insect, if the insects disappear, so the ecosystem will not balance. And maybe impact to another organism. Another organism will disappear too if the insect is disappear. So this is how insects role in the ecosystem. Insect as the friends of farmers. Insect as the friends of farmers. It means that many insects are beneficial to the farm. They can act as pollinator, pest control, biological agent, or decomposing or recycling, and soil improvement. This is how parasitoid looks like. This is the white one is white one is a biological agent. The caterpillar is surrounded by wasp cocoons. Parasitoid family Braconidae. So this caterpillar is already parasitized by this Hymenoptera Braconidae, and this is also biological agents parasitoid. What is the differences between predator, parasitoid, and parasites? Predator is organism that attacks, kills, and feeds on other organism. So they eat other organism. They prey itu memangsa. So all of this life they would hunting a prey. They akan memangsa terus ya. Predator, that is predator. The example of predator is praying mantis is belalang sembah, that is predator. And the parasitoid is organism that live on or in other organism, and they will kill the host, because the host is insect itself, and they may live externally. They can live externally. The term is ectoparasitoid, or they can live internally. Endoparasitoid, we can study more later. And they always kill the host. Parasite, this is organism that live at the expense of other organism. Yeah. They do not kill the host. Yeah. They also can act as live as ectoparasite or internally endo. So endo is internally, yeah, endoparasitoid. Parasites don't usually kill the host, so they only disturb the organism. So many insects as a friends of farmer, as a natural enemies, muso alami, are natural enemies or biological agents like parasitoid and predator and parasites. And pollination, as you can see in these pictures, you already know this is the family of Apis. You can see in these legs. In this leg, they hold a nectar. They hold some of parts of plants, so they can help to pollinate the crops, pollinate the plants. Okay. Okay, pollination. Pollinator also receive nectar or pollen rewards from the flower they visit. They eat the nectar, and the nectar provide pollinator protein, fats, and etc. Okay, and now so this the insect itself, the Apis. Now there is there is a tragedy. It's called colony collapse disorder. There is a trend. A trend that can treat the beast life, akan mengancam kehidupan dari honeybee. This is colony collapse disorder in America. This is the trend, colony collapse disorder. Okay, what is colony collapse disorder? Okay, yeah. So we will study a bit about colony collapse disorder. Colony collapse disorder is a phenomena, abnormal phenomena that occur when the majority of worker bees, Apis mellifera, in honeybee colony disappear. So, colony collapse disorder, abnormal phenomena that occur the majority of worker bees, yeah. So the insect, the Apis itself is a social insect. So they have many caste in their colony. Mereka mempunyai banyak kasta, ya. Just like in a termite, they have many caste. Some of caste is worker bees. So colony collapse disorder is abnormal phenomena when the majority of worker bees, kasta pekerja of Apis mellifera, is disappear in a colony. Yeah, this phenomena called colony collapse is disorder in late 2006. Yeah, in North America. So there is a decrease colony in Apis mellifera. Okay, the collapse of the bees colony is a significant economic problem. Yeah, why? Because bees are one of the pollinators of agricultural crop, which important in European trading community. So this is colony collapse disorder. Why this happened? It's The colony collapse disorder might occur because the using of pesticide neonicotinoid. Yeah. Some of the researchers said that also the effect of the infection of varroa and acarapis. This is the mites, so they parasitized by the mites and pathogens, and also from the habitat destructions. Yeah, their habitat is decreasing, and the change in the beekeeping pattern or combination of these factors. So this is how the colony collapse disorder happens, not only the because of the pesticide, but also the infection of parasites, maybe habitat is destruction, and or a combination of other factors. Now, this is the neonicotinoid. This is the neonicotinoid, a systemic insecticide present in most crop seeds. This is the insecticide, yeah, that used in oversize. Overseas. So in overseas, they use neonicotinoid in their crop, and they use too much neonicotinoid, and this is have a bad impact, have a adverse impact to ecological effect, including the honeybee collapse, a colony collapse disorder, or CCD. Yeah, this is the risk of for bees and other animal. The use of neonicotinoid, yeah, the impact is not only in honeybees, bumblebees, and wild bees, but also they have a bad impact in other insect like birds and other insect like odonata, butterfly and moth, and other land invertebrate. So they have a impact. Neonicotinoid seed treatment, yeah. So they use seed treatment also in their corn and their mice, and you can imagine that one corn seed can kill, yeah, can kill a much of bees, 160,000 bees can be killed because of the seed treatment. Neonicotinoid have been registered in more than 120 countries, and they represent 24% of the global market of insecticide. So this is how we should reduce the use of neonicotinoid, because it have a bad impact to our ecosystem. Okay, other role of insect as a decomposing and soil improvement. The maggot larvae Diptera calliporidae also, they can decompose the organic matter, and this is dung beetles. They help to decompose this organic matter from feces of other animal. They make ball, then they decompose this decomposite. Decomposition is the most important because it allows organic matter to be recycled in ecosystem. Dung beetles I already explained to you, yeah, known as rulers, roll dung into round balls, and this is the dung. Dung is kotoran, salah satu kotoran sapi, which use as a food source or breeding chambers. So they decompose this dung kotoran, these feces into their breeding places, breeding chamber, and the food source. It's a great role in the ecosystem. By burying and consuming dung, they improve nutrient recycling and soil structure. How are insects harmful to agriculture and houses? Yeah, some of insects act as a pest. Yeah, there are a lot of pests, as you already know, in the ecosystem. Yeah, pests not only arthropod, not only insect, but there is pests, another mollusca, nematoda, pathogen, and so weeds. Yeah, so insect have several roles in the ecosystem. Insects are pests when some of the insect we call it pests when they can reduce the quantity or quality of the food and feed during production. They damage the commodities during harvesting, processing, marketing, and storing. For example, this is the pest. This is the stored product pest. Stored pest is Hamagudang, the rice weevil, Citophilus oryzae, Coleoptera curculionidae. Yeah, they destroy the rice in the storage. Yeah, di penyimpanan. This is aphid. They can transmit the disease. Yeah, this is bed bugs. Bed bugs have a bad impact to human. Injure or annoy human, damage ornamental plants, and damage home and other personal property. As you know, in a previous we already study about the urban pest. Yeah, cause of pest outbreak in agriculture. How the pest outbreak happen? Because monocultures in might because of the introduction of new varieties and crops. Introduction of new species of pests or invasion of new species of pests. Yeah, some of the pests is come from overseas. There is a new pest in new pests in Indonesia. For example, this is the Spodoptera frugiperda. They enter Indonesia in 2019, and now they infect all of the place in Indonesia in maize crops. The pest outbreak, it could be because of the climate change. Yeah. Pest outbreak, it might also could be from the spacing of plants is too narrow, or continuity of planting, there is no change in community, so we have to change our community. For example, we can we can plant not only paddy in the whole year, but we can change into another commodity. For example, we can plant paddy and then maize and paddy again. So there is a break. Planting period and the use excessive of pesticide also lead the pest outbreak in agriculture. The impact is crop failure. Yeah. Decrease in quantity and quality of crop and rejection of export commodities. Insect as a pest in house, you already know from the previous semester, there are a lot of urban pests, for example, ants, cockroach, mosquito, and termites, and other. This is the last is Vespa affinis. Vespa affinis is look like it is in the pictures. It's a common hornet in tropical subtropical Asia, and this is dangerous. The highest number of death relating Hymenoptera stings. They have a sting and they can make the human become deaf because of the failure in organ. Yeah? The nest of Vespa affinis is in a trees. This is the nest in a subtropical and neotropical. The nest is usually in trees. In a tropical area, the pear shapes is like that, and while in a subtropical area, oval. The nest is oval. So you have to be careful to this insect, because this insect is very dangerous. Kenali tawon Vespa affinis. Vespa affinis become dangerous when attacking in groups. So they live in colony while they disturbing by something, so they can attack the human, and the human could be dead. In nature, Vespa affinis act as a predator. They act as a biological agent. So, but if they sting the human could be death if they attacking in groups. So this is the last take home assignments. Just you should make a resume, and a resume like from lectures and the video. The link will be available in Google Classroom, and you should looking for these three things, yeah, about integrated pest management, and you can write in the resume. Okay, thank you for today. I hope you understand what in the lecture today. Okay, see you next time. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.